culture of Indian major carps. Before that, we know what is meant by carp. Important thing. Carp means those fishes, toothless mouth. Toothless mouth means carp. Example, more and more example. Within that, Katala, Rohu, Brigal, all are the carps. The title of that unit 1, that is the culture of Indian major carps. The next question is that, what is meant by Indian major carps? Indian major carps means those fishes whose native is India, which are used for the commercial purpose, which are used for the commercial purpose in India, called the Indian major carps. They are the major. Examples, Katla, Rohu and Mrigal. Carps means toothless mouse, and Indian major carps means which are used for the commercial purpose in India, called the Indian major carps. Within that, one fish we will see today, that is the labio, that is the Rohu. Biology of labio. First of all, we see about the classification of labio. Phylum Chordata, group Pisces, class Osteichthyes, order Cypriniformes, family Cyprinidae, genus Labio, and species Rohita. This is about the classification of fish. Next one, about the concept of our biology, that is the external character. The scientific name of Rohu is Labio Rohita. This is the scientific name. External characters. Body is elongated with rounded abdomen, generally 45 to 60 cm in length. Color is brownish gray, black above. Scales are large and orange, reddish in color. Head is prominent, lips are thick. Mouth is subterminal. One point is that mouth is subterminal, means upper jaw is longer than lower jaw. One point. Number two, if the fish belonging to the upturned mouth, then it is a surface feeder. Subterminal, column feeder. If the mouth is terminal, then the fish is a bottom feeder. But about specially about our labio rohita, that is mouth is subterminal, it means that the fish is a column feeder. Three level in the water: surface, column and bottom. The next point, that is caudal fin, is forked and barbels are absent. The next item, that is the food and feeding habit of labio. Already I told that is it is a column feeder fish. Mouth is subterminal, that means that the column feeder fish. It feeds on vegetables, debris, microscopic plant, decayed and mud. All vegetables are feeds upon the labio, means it is a purely herbivorous in nature. Then next one, that is the spawning season. Spawning season and breeding season both are the same. Spawning season of labio in June to August, river Ganga. It breed from August. The scientist David, he found that in 1959, breeding season of labio, that is the August. But as per references of book, generally the labio rohita breeds, means spawning, end of June up to the first week of September. In 4 months is the breeding period of labio rohita. The next one, that is the maturity. Labio attained a maturity at the end of second year. One special point, that is the about the labio. Male mature early than the female. Important point, that is the male mature early than the female. The next title of our biology, that is the fecundity. Before that fecundity, we know what is meant by the fecundity or the definition of fecundity. This is important concept for the purpose of 1 marks also. Definition, exam, will ask in the exam also. Fecundity means number of eggs laid by female fish per gram, its body weight, called the fecundity. Means fecundity is depend upon the ovary, length and weight of that fish. The absolute fecundity of labio depend upon the weight of ovary and length. It is an important concept. The labio range from 51 to 75 centimeter its length, and weight 1.5 to 7.6 kg was found to vary from 4,25,600 to 27,94,000 x. This is the absolute fecundity of labium. The next concept, that is the growth. In good nursery pond, hatching of labium when stocked at the rate 10 to 12.5 lakhs per hectare, then the length of labium 30 mm in 15 days. Next concept, according to the Hora, the scientist, 1962, he observed that labium grow length 35 to 45 centimeter in 1 year. At the time of 1 year, it weighed 900 gram, near about to 1 kg, as per research by Hora. 2 to 3 kg at the end of second year and 4 to 5 kg at the end of third year. It is a growth period. 2 to 3 second year, 4 to 5 at the end of third year. After 4 year, completion after 4 year of labio maturity, it grows slowly. Means fasting rate in the year of second and third, but grow slowly after the completion of 4 years. This is the growth duration time of labio. The next one is a distribution. Already I told it is a freshwater fish. It has been transplanted in many countries. It also found in Bangladesh and Burma. The last concept of our biology, that is the economic important. What is meant by the economically important? What is the economic? Means what the economy we will get from the fish of labium. Quickly growing carp means it grow fastly. It is the plus point. It is the beneficial for the fishermen also, or they are culturing the labium. It is important that is the growing carp is fastly. Number two, it is a large use for culture in pond all over the country. And next one, it is a valuable feed fish. Vitamin A and vitamin D are present in the fish, and it is a fastly growing for the purpose of that point of view. It solves the unemployment problem. Those fishermen is suffering from the unemployment. They can culture the labium and solve the unemployment problem. This is the important thing of economical importance. Thank you.